Hello, I'm Orrin Otter. 8 equals negative 3 is the show all about things which science has gotten wrong. Things like the ideas that arteries don't carry blood, or that bleeding is good for you, or that Jerry Doyle is actually Bruce Willis running an elaborate tax evasion scam. Most of the time, this show has been about debunking the theory of evolution. However, I try to be open-minded. When the evidence comes to light which supports evolution, I'll speak openly about it. Some of you may have seen the picture which is circulating around the internet of a celestial object photographed by the Hubble Space Telescope. The object is called CFR-040115. It is enormous. So how can a distant object in the night sky affect evolution? Well, let me explain. The biggest problem evolution faces is that it is incredibly improbable. I've heard the odds of evolution placed by a panel of experts at 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 70 to 1 against. That's a big number. But let's start smaller. In my recent video, Amino Acids in Ponies, I established that for a working protein to self-assemble in a soup of random amino acids, each acid molecule added to the protein took the improbability up by two orders of magnitude. Now, with the laws of chemistry aside, this means that a working 50-acid protein forming on its own, it has an improbability level of a Google to 1 against. That's a 1 with 100 zeros to 1 against. You would need a lot of luck to pull that off. So exactly what would it take to generate that much improbability, assuming that you don't have Douglas Adams and a fresh cup of really hot tea? Well, how about a standard Lucky Charm? If a 2-inch rabbit's foot has the power to cause a fortuitous coin flip once per day, how big would one have to be to give us our improbability field? Well, first, we figure the size necessary to cause it in one day, then we divide by 365 billion, giving it a billion years to do the job. Now, doubling the length of the foot would increase the luck by a factor of 8 thanks to the square cube law. But to be generous, let's assume that the lower proportional surface area allows less luck to be lost to entropy, and say that the luck available increases by a factor of 10. At 1 meter, the foot now possesses the power to generate an improbability field of 1 million to 1. At 2 meters, 10 million to 1. To reach an improbability level of a quintillion to 1 against, we now have a foot slightly less than 4 kilometers long. Not bad so far. At an improbability level of 10 to the power of 45, the foot is now 550 billion kilometers. Or 340 billion miles. At 10 to the power of 46, the foot is now longer than a light year. At 10 to the power of 47, it exceeds the total length of the solar system. At 10 to the power of 53 to 1 against, the foot has now exceeded the size of the Milky Way galaxy. At 10 to the power of 80, a rabbit's foot has now exceeded the size of the entire observable universe. By the time we reach an improbability level of a Google to 1, by which point Ford has long since turned into a penguin, our rabbit's foot is now a million times the length of the universe. Now, if we continue to go on from there, the luck needed to keep the rabbit's foot from imploding under its own gravity would exceed its capacity to generate it. So, 10 to the 15 light years. But remember, we need to divide by time. That gives us 10 to the power of 6 divided by 365, or 2,740 light years. An object that size would be smaller than the Milky Way galaxy. For you Star Trek nerds, we're talking about the size of the United Federation of Planets. That's a much more manageable size. Again, this would only produce enough luck to produce a single small protein. That's a Google to 1 against. To accomplish molecules to man evolution, we have to jump to 10 to the power of 1 with 70 zeros following it. Such a rabbit's foot is literally beyond human comprehension in size. Now, earlier, I showed you a photo of CRF-040115. The object isn't very clear in this photo, but I would like to show you just what this picture looks like when cleaned up a little and combined with scans in the infrared, radio, X-ray, ultraviolet, and sideways green spectra. This is CRF-040115, a cosmic rabbit's foot. This object is over 200,000 light years long. That's the distance from here to the small Magellanic Cloud. No one knows where this object came from, though some have speculated that it came from a giant rabbit who challenged the tortoise on whose back the world is perched, on the back of four elephants, to a race, and losing the race, lost his foot in a hastily made wager. Personally, I believe that when Jesus gave Peter the keys to the kingdom, this is the keychain he took them from. In any case, it goes a long way toward explaining incredibly improbable things, like Paris being considered romantic, William Shatner's recording an album, and Richard Dawkins being taken seriously. Thank you for watching, and happy April Fool's Day.